Another splendid episode of Sword Art Online 2. Oh my god, you all don't know how I feel right now. They are really sticking to the source material. They are really doing it. Three episodes in. And they're sticking to it, man. We're still technically in the prologue. They're finally doing this anime justice. This anime, Sword Art Online, is being adapted properly. I was so shocked in seeing that entire nurse scene. I thought they were going to actually cut that scene in this. And then to see that nurse scene, how they actually just show that nurse scene, even though it was useless information technically, they still showed it. I was like, they're really sticking to the fucking light novel. They're even showing that. So I'm like, yeah. You don't know how much this means, because this is going to be a good-ass adaptation if they continue at this pace. Now, I have noticed a lot of people have been complaining these past couple episodes, saying it's too slow-paced, too much exposition. This is still technically the prologue of the Gun Gale Online arc, so technically, it's supposed to take this long. The main point of these past three episodes is just setup. It's setup for the future events, it's showcasing different things going on, trying to show you the introduction to Shion's character, and at the same time, seeing Kirito's decision to go back into the virtual reality and you do a freaking case for the government. So this three episodes have been so fucking badass, because I enjoy getting to see how this is just being handled properly for once in a long time. A light novel is being adapted properly. It's not being fucking rushed. It's not getting bitch slapped backhanded by any freaking company. Aniplex or whatever, whoever's the studio of this right now, A1 Pictures, whoever's doing this. That is all I want to say to you fucking badass. That's all. Thumbs fucking up. Thumbs up for all that, because that's just, yeah. Okay, so this episode, what to do? Let's talk about the plot. Enough fangasming on how they're keeping the original source intact. Let's talk about this episode. Okay, so this episode, on point with the animation. Animation looked really fucking good. Even when the character's face is in the distance, it still looked badass. The animation looked fluid. I love the background art. The background art looked really good. And so I have no complaints there, so I can move past the animation. So pretty much this episode didn't really have any fighting whatsoever. The main focus of the episode was Shino's character, getting to see more about her, getting to see how she was in real life, and at the same time getting to see her trauma. That's the main central focus of this arc, and at the same time Shion as a character, because you see her trauma. She killed someone when she was really young to protect her mother, and you see when she shot this person to death, shot him three times. I thought they were going to censor that a little bit more, but they didn't censor it. I was like, what the fuck? So it was really cool. It was exactly what I envisioned in my mind. They kept those emotions intact from the light novel, and I like that. And I like how they use the inner monologues with the characters in this episode, and they managed to keep them intact too. I mean, we may have not seen any dialogue in their mind, but they kept the inner monologues with the flashbacks, and that's something I really respect how they're doing with this adaptation of SAO2. Now, that entire scene with Shion attacking that dude, the robber, okay, and defending herself and defending her mother and defending everybody, that was a really emotional scene, because you get to see what type of character Shion is as a character. We see her development. We see that she has a major fear of guns. She doesn't like touching them, holding them in real life. She can't even have, like, gestures of a gun, and she gets scared of it. And you can clearly see she's getting bullied in this episode by fellow female characters in this series, because they want money and different stuff like that. So Shion has a major weakness. At the same time, this weakness doesn't carry over into the virtual reality Gun Gale Online, which is really unique in the way she's using the virtual reality game of Gun Gale Online to actually have exposure therapy to guns. It's really unique to her character, and I love that and respect that about Shion and the writer of this series, because usually this type of development would be kind of skipped over a little bit. They would kind of make it more shallow, but the way they're actually emphasizing this development, it really shocked me in this episode, because I thought they were going to skip over major details trying to jump into Gun Gale Online, but no. They didn't do that. They actually stuck to the real source material, developed Shion as a character, one of the main iconic characters in this fucking series after his arc, and then so they do that. So I'm happy. I'm really happy. This was a good episode. There wasn't really much anything they skipped out. This was perfectly adapted, I think. There was only a couple scenes, but that's not important at all, because they can possibly cover it. I feel personally like this is going to be an epic-ass ride. If they continue at this pacing, they continue with this development, it's definitely going to be good. And all those anime-only watchers that are currently watching this, most likely you're probably bored to fucking death. You're probably wanting to see nothing but action. You probably want to see Lightsaber Kirito cutting people in half from the opening song. But I'm going to let you know now, Sword Art Online 2, or Sword Online in general, is about the world and characters. It's technically not supposed to be about the action like they showed in the first season. That was just A1 Pictures trying to cop out and get easy money. This time, they're actually adapting it right and keeping true to the source material. So if you're looking for action all around, 24 freaking minutes long in each episode, you're not going to get that. You should expect a badass story from Gun Gal Online. So, overall, good episode. I would rate it a 9 out of 10. It's not the best. It has a couple problems. Yes, nothing's really perfect, but it was a good episode. I like the setup of it. I like getting to see the character development, getting to see more of Shion as a character, and at the same time, I love how it's going. So anyways, everybody, tell me your thoughts about this episode. Did you enjoy it? Did you hate it? What'd you feel about this episode? All of you anime-only watchers out there right now, let me know how you feel about these past 3 episodes. Are you happy to know that this is being adapted properly? Are you bored? Do you hate this? Or do you want to see more freaking action? Please let me know in the comments below. And all light novel readers, once again, I want to state, please do not spoil nothing about upcoming events. If you're going to talk about spoilers, please put a spoiler tag above your comment, because I don't want to spoil anime only watchers. So anyways, everybody, I love all of you so much. You have a wonderful day or night wherever you live. Please be safe. Chibi out.